It's Malanka time, motherfuckers, and today on Malanka Talks, we're going to be talking about how to get started in YouTube and what you need to do or what you need to really, I don't want to say be successful because it depends on the person and their ambition and their charisma and other things like this, but overall things that you need to get started, and I believe I could point people in the right direction. Now, I'm no PewDiePie or I'm no saint, I'm no fucking godlike at this, but I have been doing this for, I don't know, since 2009, so I have a feeling I've known some ins and outs and what to do and what not to do. So, let's get started. Now, the first thing you're going to need is a good computer. Yeah, you're going to need a good computer. No one wants to watch you play a game. Not only are you lagging, and it looks like you're playing on fucking diarrhea. Okay, so you're going to need a computer. Now, you could technically do this with a half-assed computer a little bit, if you choose your games right. But usually, you know, it depends on the games and other things like that. Computer power also equals render power for editing videos and such, but that's a little bit later. So you're going to need a computer. My computer is an AMD 8-core with 8 gigs of DDR3 with a GTX 970 and like a 700-watt power supply. And just a normal I don't even forget how big my hard drive is, because I don't know. I think it's like 800 or even a terabyte almost. But my computer is not the greatest. It definitely isn't, and yes, I know an AMD 8-core. Yes, please, give the hate. Give the hate. But overall, my computer's okay. It's budget. That's why I got the AMD. The AMD was cheaper at the time, and yada, yada, yada. So you could kind of base, if you really want to build a computer, you could base your computer around mine if you're really on a budget. Or you could actually do research and just Google things and just find a good motherboard to match, you know, an i7 processor. Maybe, you know, RAM is easier to find. Find a graphics card that you don't have to get the top of the line or something like a Titan, you know. But you have to research, like, okay, what are the graphics cards that are coming out, how are they performing, because some graphics card may have more RAM or processing power, may just be unstable and may just be shit completely, some of the times that is the case. So do your research ahead of time, and you could easily find deals online and put together your own computer, and you could either have a friend or bring it to a shop and have them put it together for some kind of fee, etc., etc. Next up is your YouTube channel name. Now, you would think it's just a YouTube channel name. Some people don't understand. Some people just create Army Man 101101, something they've used since they was 5. And then they decided to use it as a YouTube channel and try to be somewhat successful. It just doesn't work. It takes 2 minutes to go to Gmail, create a proper Gmail address, and then create a YouTube, a brand new YouTube. There is nothing hard with this. Absolutely nothing. But now you're thinking, how do I choose a username? Well, here's the thing. Think of it as a wrestling gimmick, because that's how I always thought of it. Because look at the Malanka. Empire and Rommel, it's something completely fucking different. But the Malanka is a good example. Malanka means jerk off. Someone who's ignorant. Someone who's just doesn't have any common sense. And this reflects my commentary style. So it fits. It's a gimmick. You know, and just think of other stuff like this. Like, there's one I just thought of that I'll kind of give away, is that a good channel name would be The Edelweiss. Or the Black Edelweiss. The reason I say black is not because I am black, because I'm more whiter than snow, but because I actually have a book called The Black Edelweiss that was written by a German soldier who joined late in the war and all this other stuff. It's a pretty good book. But you could like that. It'd be perfect. You already have an emblem, the Edelweiss, and if you're a total fucking weeaboo Nazi person, it completely fits, because then you could be a weeaboo Nazi person. You know what I mean? Do you know what I mean? So something like this is going to make people remember you and make you, and you could almost think of it as a brand almost, to think of yourself expanding later on or whatever. So that's kind of the way you have to think about it. This next part is about what kind of games you're going to cover. And also, on a little side note, get some fucking channel art and a decent avatar, please. You could hire a graphic artist, or you could learn Photoshop. It's one of the two. Choose. Yeah, please choose a decent channel art and avatar. So for games, a lot of people have problems with this. They should just play the games they like, I generally think, because it will show that you're having fun, at least in the game. But some games I don't recommend doing, like extremely popular games. Now, sometimes I do this. You don't see me do a lot of popular games, which I try to stay away from. But like, if you're a Call of Duty fan, don't play Call of Duty. Just like making Battlefield 1 videos, I really doubt you're going to get anywhere with your channel with Battlefield 1. Unless you make some godlike montages, then I don't know. I really don't. But usually, if you like the same games that I do, that real t I like all types of games, but usually I like RTS and RPG games. I think that you should start off with Total War. I started off with Total War. I tell people to, because Total War is always, to me at least, a little bit refreshing because there's different ways to go about things. No, gameplay or campaign is the same from two Let's Players' perspectives, unless magically they do or whatever. But overall, it's, yeah, it'll give you can expand upon that, and with that, you can then expand your commentary and stuff like this. Now, I'm not saying don't go for the games that are complete indie and no one knows about, but usually what I do, and I think that works, is that you have a mainstay of your channel. Like me, it's Company of Heroes, Hearts of Iron, whatever. And then if I have Company of Heroes, I always have a second playthrough of a game that not a lot of people like on my channel or not a lot of people do know, sort of like Styx when I did it, Styx Master of Shadow. The Witcher 3, again, a very popular game. A lot of people did do it, but I thoroughly enjoyed it. But I still did a playthrough on it anyways because I thoroughly enjoyed it and I think it is a great game. But you have that game, The Witcher 3, at least for me, in my perspective, The Witcher 3 being supported by Company of Heroes. So people keep coming back because you're doing Company of Heroes, and then they see, oh, The Witcher, I think I may take a look at this and see if they like it. Something like this. That's kind of what you want to have in your arsenal. And that's how you kind of want to go about it. But that's just my opinion. That's how I found what works for me. Of course, it's definitely going to work different for you. But that's where I think someone should start for video wise, or no, for game wise. And yeah. Now, in terms of recording, you could use Framps or Shadowplay. These are the only two options I'm giving you because these are the only two that work to a point. Actually, Shadowplay works very good. So here's the thing: a lot of people, the staple is Fraps. Everyone uses Fraps, or a lot of people use OBS. I don't give one shit about OBS. A lot of people use Fraps. Now, the thing with recording is that a lot of the files are huge, like my dick. They're going to be huge. You're going to need hard drive space. But of course, you would record a bunch, render and upload them, like schedule them. So they're uploaded out of your hard drive, and then you would delete them, and then you get all that room back. But first off, you need a lot of room. With Framps is an easy $20. You buy it, and for me, this is personally for me, I've heard other different stories. Sometimes in games, it works flawlessly. Flawless. And in other games, it completely doesn't want to work. It craps itself. It doesn't care whatsoever. Now that's my opinion about Fraps. Now you could use Fraps, it's very easy to use. You turn it on and you click F9 when you're in a game and you're recording. Wow, so hard. But the other one that I completely recommend over Fraps is Shadowplay. Now with Shadowplay you need NVIDIA and you need Windows 7 and the requirements, whatever the requirements are. Shadowplay is exactly like Fraps, but I think it's better because you don't have any potential to lag in game. As long as your computer can handle recording and playing a game the game at the same time, it is completely superior. You can record in 720p, 1080p, different bit rates on Shadowplay, and it, again, like I said, it doesn't lag. It's very simple and very easy, and I like it completely. It is way better than Fraps in my opinion. But that's what I use. You could use whatever you want. Again, you can do more research to find different recording programs and or whatever. Or maybe you have a favorite YouTuber that uses a specific recording program and you trust his opinion over mine. It's okay. I don't give one fuck. But yeah, that's my opinion on recording. So before we talk about rendering, we're going to talk about your microphone really quick. Now, I could technically put this in the computer section, but I think here, since we're talking about recording, you're going to want to know how to record your... Well, not know how to record your voice, but know a microphone that can record good. Now, I'm going to be honest with you. I'm going to give you no bullshit. What anyone has ever probably told you is a load of shit, to a point, is that, yes, you can buy a Blue Yeti or an expensive microphone, buy a soundboard mixer, whatever you want to call it, hook it up to your computer and be the extreme sound Nazi that you truly want to be. But I think it's a little bit overkill. I think you can get a decent headset microphone and record it like mine. I'm using a headset microphone, and I think this headset works fairly well and sounds very good for its price and everything else like that. You could listen to me for a couple, just a good amount of hours without your ears bleeding. Now, unless you hate my voice, but it's a whole different story. Now, I'm going to tell you what I use. I use a Platonic headset. The link to both these things will be in the description. And then I use a USB port, because this Platonic headset is the green and pink thing that go in the back of your computer into the sound plugs. Now, you don't want to put it into the sound plugs, or any headset for that matter, only because you get extreme static in your mic. That's why I used to put a noise suppression. This is the same microphone I've been using since the very beginning. And my microphone was horrible for a long time until I discovered this. And you may be thinking, wow, Rommel, you're pretty stupid, but I didn't have anyone to tell me or find out. I didn't know what to look up. A lot of people would just say, get this mic, it's easier, get this, get that. So I plug it in to the USB port, and my mic works fine. It's a little bit more sensitive now. Of course, you could hear people taking a shit, you could hear the phone, the sound, everything else really well. But if you have your own recording space, or you live, you know, by yourself, or actually have a quiet room or a quiet family, then you could easily record without any sound problems with other people. And even then, if you have the money, you should probably get a Blue Yeti, or if you really want to put forth all the effort and have the top quality, you know, top budget video, then yeah, you should. But otherwise, I don't think so. The only thing you really need is a good mic that works, that sounds really good, that's not that expensive, and a quiet room to record in. That's all you need, really. And that's my opinion. One thing I will note, though, about the Platonic headset is that it does die after 6 months. I haven't found a better headset since this one. You technically could experiment with other type of headsets that are like this one with the double plug and put it in the USB and see how it works. I'm not willing to spend $180 for a headset that only lasts a year. I might as well use this one because I've always been using it and I like it. And I just know it. I know the devil. Now, this is, again, all my opinion on this matter. Some people may have other things. You could probably find a really good mic that's like the Blue Yeti, but it's very quiet. I know one exists, but I forget the name right now. But you can find it online. Again, research. But this is the key, though, to basically everything that I'm telling everyone in this video, because I feel like this is the problem that a lot of people do have, is the microphone quality and everything else like that. Now, there's also one thing I do want to add here at the end, is that your your Fraps or your Shadowplay will record your gameplay. If you really want to be even more Nazi, you would use Audacity. Basically, this is how you did it back in the old days, 09 less, is that what you would do is you would open up Sony Vegas, you would click record, mute your mic, because then you wouldn't see any of the sound waves, and then when you did record, you would unmute, and then you would see the sound waves, so you knew when to cut off, etc., etc. This is kind of, I feel like, the same way that you do with Audacity. I haven't used it, or there's probably a special shortcut for it to start recording, and then you match it up, and then you'll be able to raise your voice or lower it. But I think that's too much of a hassle. You could just go in-game and test it out in 5-10 minutes and probably get a decent assumption of your voice and your game volume, and it should be completely fine. So we're going to talk about rendering. Now, I don't know much about rendering, I'm going to admit it, but I'm going to give my few cents on it and just a little gist of it. Rendering is where you put clips together in Sony Vegas or Adobe or whatever program you so choose, and then they put them together, rendering them at a certain resolution and pixel rate or whatever, and then you upload it to YouTube. Oh, and it compresses too. So, I recommend Sony Vegas, because that's what I use. You could use whatever program you want. Now, you could YouTube this, you could YouTube what program is best to use, what template I could use for gameplay. Now, I only render in 720p, because to me, you cannot tell the difference between 720 and 1080p unless you're on a big monitor. Now, I really doubt the majority of my fan base is running a huge fucking monitor, but, you know, whatever. I think 720p looks fine. To me, there's no difference. I render in 720p because it's easier. Now, if I had the option and the better computer power, whatever, to render in 1080 or 2K or 1K, then yes, I would. And I believe you should too if you feel like you should. There is no problem with it. But if you don't have to, might as well render in 720p. If people bitch about 1080, they can go fuck themselves because, you know, whatever. It still looks good. As long as you are using the correct resolution when rendering and recording and using the correct pixel rate or whatever the fuck it's called when you render, because like, let's say, not pixel, but like FPS, like if you record in 60 FPS, you need to render in 60 FPS. Very simple, very simple. But there are templates that you can use on, not use, but go off of on YouTube. You can just say best 720p Sony Vegas gaming rendering template or whatever. I totally worded that bad. And you could easily find hundreds of videos doing different things, and you could try all of them differently. Here's my tip. When you do this, let's say you choose someone's video and you're going to use their template, which is very easy to follow and set up. Just render a minute of a video and upload it to YouTube, because YouTube does a compression, even though Sony Vegas or Adobe will do a compression anyways, which sometimes can fuck up the quality of your video. And see, after it's done processing, if you like the quality. If you like the quality, then stick to that template. And I think you should do that for every game, because every game is a little bit different, in my opinion. Because Company of Heroes used to be dotty. I had to find a special template for it, and then now it's okay. So, just be careful, test things out, and again, research, motherfuckers, research. So now we're going to talk about something that doesn't actually take, well, it doesn't take something to buy or to learn. Well, it does take a lot of time to learn, is that your commentary. Your commentary is going to take time to develop and learn over time. It is going to reflect who you are and what you do and what you want it to become and blah, 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 blah. Now, the one thing I always find funny is that a lot of people who do YouTube actually have no fucking charisma. I would love to name a few names because I kind of have them at the ready, but I'm not going to. But if you lack charisma, it's going to hurt you. I believe I have charisma to a point. I'm not a full charismatic enigma. Woodstock will get this joke. But over time, your commentary will develop. Just like go back on Empire and Rommel, watch my first video. Completely bad. So bad, horrible, fucking bullshit. But look at my commentary now. Completely bad, horrible, fucking bullshit. But a little bit better. So you just have to work on it and just constantly work. Yes, phone. Even the phone agrees. Praise my cell phone. Beep, beep. The phone agrees. It just takes time. Now, this is going to be kind of a miscellaneous section here because I've kind of put this into section, at least in Sony Vegas. But overall, you kind of get the gist. You got the recording. You getting working on the commentary and stuff like this. There's only a couple things. One, you're going to need a Twitter or a Facebook just so people can reach out to you and talk to you. That is painfully obvious. One thing you will need to do if you want to is add in front of your videos where people can follow you so people know, instead of in the description, because who reads the fucking description? Another thing too is thumbnails. Thumbnails are very easy to make. A lot of people put way too much effort in the fucking thumbnail with some stupid ass pictures. It the more stupider it looks, the more I don't click on it. At least that's for me personally. A lot of other people are, you know, do whatever. Usually what I do is, hopefully I do put it on the screen here, is that, well, first you go to Google. I type in, let's say if I'm doing a walkthrough for Homefront. I'll just use an example. I go Google Images. I find a relatively decent picture that I like. And then I go to, there's a specific site that I go to. It's called Cool Text. And I usually use the one that's as keen, and then I put like number 7, number 8, and I make it white, and then I make it a little bit big, and then I just save a whole bunch of them so I don't have to go back to the site. And then in Paint, yes, I use Paint. I just paste from and then remove the transparency, and then I put it in the corner, and it looks nice. I don't even do anything magically. Now, again, some people put a lot of effort into this with Photoshop and everything. Sure, you can. Again, this is the long-term decent effect of Photoshop, but yeah. Also, you don't need to put thumbnails on fucking everything. There's a lot of people like Woodstock or Grayshot who put a thumbnail kind of on Company of Heroes all the time, which I think is kind of, I don't know. I think it's stupid. But then you could say it's stupid to put thumbnail on everything. The only reason I say that is because I think that Company of Heroes is a special beast where there's just so many different things going on in every different game. And I think if people see that if it's a summer or winter map, or if they see a tank or an explosion or some infantry, that'll work. If you just have a normal Company of Heroes 2 cast, number 7, and then, no picture, just like a basic picture, like Woodstock has, like black and white with the faction symbols or whatever. And I don't know, it just doesn't, it's just bleh. It's just bleh. That's why, also, especially with things like Company of Heroes, is that you don't want to create. I've learned this a little bit recently, is that you want to have, when you're creating the title, so we got the thumbnail down, but the title. Also, you want to have good tags too. Create good fucking tags and put effort into it, you cunt. With tag, not with tag, with the title, like what I do now is I put Company of, instead of, well, I did before. I used to do Company of Heroes 1 gameplay number 35. But there's no incentive that you may like it. It's just another gameplay. So that's why I started to put, for the Malacca Company of Heroes 2 cast number, whatever, and then a couple word description like, you are all shit. The gayest match of the year, very intelligent titles, not really. But that's kind of what you want to do so people could be like, oh my God, this has something I may want to watch or laugh at or something. Just like my one of my videos says, you are all dumb. So you know this match is going to be a complete cringe fest, and some people like it, some people don't, and that's kind of how it goes. But at least I feel like that gets a little bit more viewership and entices people to come and watch. At least that's what I have felt. Other than this, I can't. Oh, there's one more thing. At least I think. I'll probably forget something and I'll be really angry that I did. Is partnership. The last one is partnership. Do not partner with anyone except Curse. You want to partner with Curse only. Now, I am. So this is the reason. So TGN sucks and Maker Studio. I was currently signed to Maker Studio on Empire Unravel. They fucked me good. And you may be saying, oh, this is just a personal story. They may not. They're gonna fuck you too. It's fucking Disney. Disney owns Maker Studio. And the reason Disney sucks is because their support sucks. And I used to make a certain amount of money, which I will not disclose. I used to make a certain amount of money, and a whole bunch of hidden fees appeared, and they fucked me really good on that money. And I couldn't get out of my contract to boot, because what they do is that when you first sign. What they do is that they do it a 2-year contract or a 1 year, and then with the next contract after that year, they have it automatically renewing, so you don't forget about you forget about it, and yeah, so there's no point in time that the contract is ending and then you could leave. It's a continuous cycle to where they kind of fuck you good. Now, unfortunately, this is another problem I had with them, is that I didn't save my contract at first because I didn't think I would need it, because I thought everything was going to be peachy, but then again, I was a dumbass. Still kind of am. I tried to get them to send me a copy of my contract. 3 weeks later, after fighting with them, I finally got a copy of my contract. I don't know what was so fucking hard about it. Don't know. But the reason I say go to Curse, here's the thing. So I was getting 70% of my earnings, and the rest was going to Makers. In Curse, you get 90, they get 10 automatically. There's no working up towards it, you get it automatically. You could leave whatever you want in Curse, and that's pretty much it. Oh yeah, and they deliver your money to PayPal. Now, in Makers, I would get a check. Now, I could have gotten direct deposit, and I've asked them so many fucking times to get me a fucking direct deposit, but they never goddamn did. And so I had to go to the bank every single fucking time, which was stupid. And that was a lot of fucks in there, but that's how angry I am about it. And with Curse, you get it in PayPal on the 10th. And you could leave anytime you want. That is the key point. If you're unhappy with Curse, you could leave anytime you want. With Makers and probably TGN, you have to give a 30-day notice. And even then, it's very hard to get contact with their support to tell them that you are giving them your notice. And you would like for them to schedule your release when the contract ends. You have to wait till the contract ends. And sometimes even if you ask them to terminate your contract, they won't. So you have to be careful here. I really like Curse right now. I haven't heard a bad thing about Curse at all. I mean, you could look it up. You will hear bad shit about Makers and TGN, especially Makers dropping PewDiePie because apparently he's a Nazi, which I think is hilarious. But with TGN, you hear bad things. I would go to Curse and do it like that. That's it. Now, here's also a thing, too, is that when you join these companies and stuff, that they're not going to help you grow. Okay? It is a delusion that they are going to help you grow. If any of them say, even Curse does it, too, they claim that they're going to help you grow and they can do that. They're not going to help you with shit. No one is going to help you. You're going to have to do it all on your own. And that's the one thing I find funny where people are like, why doesn't Maker do this for me? Why doesn't TGN? They're not going to help you because that's your job. They're just here to put the ads on your video and take some of the money for doing absolutely nothing. And there you go. That's it. They're not going to help you at all. Just not. Unless you're a big YouTuber. Then they're going to put your video, if you're doing World of Warcraft or using Curse or something, or you're a big partner, sure, they'll put your, it's just like I think Epic Rap Battles of History is partnered with Maker, and if you actually go to the Maker website, you actually should see some of the Epic Rap Battles of History. Now, they don't need really promotion because they're so big, but you get what I mean. So yeah, you have to be careful with partners, read the contract, make sure you're, again, 90% is really fucking good. You're not going to get anything else like that. I mean, at Makers, again, I think I was starting at 60, and then they upgraded me to 70, and then I told them about Curse, and they were going to give me 80, but I would have to sign a new contract, and I was not going to do that. Luckily, they let me go, but yeah. So that's it. That's kind of all I could think of right now about starting off with YouTube. Again, do your research. Do your research on every part of it. Make sure you make the right effort the fucking first time. The first time you're doing it. Because you don't want to end up like me, well, to a point, when you're doing it as a kid and you don't know anything and you make shitty quality videos with a shitty mic and don't do good commentary. Well, your commentary will come with time, but you know what I mean? It's just, yeah. But anyways, I want to thank you all for watching, and I hope you enjoyed.